Does the Anthony Weiner episode make it harder for Democrats to get their agenda passed? Text A for yes, text B for no to 622-639. And of course, you can always go to our blog at ed.msnbc.com, and we'll bring you the results later on in the show. For more, let's go to our panel tonight. We're joined by Melissa Harris Perry, a professor of political science at Tulane University and a columnist for The Nation magazine, and Mike Papantonio, host of the Ring of Fire radio show. Great to have both of you with us tonight. Melissa, you first. The picture's out. His wife is pregnant. What does this change, if anything, in your opinion?
Well, I mean, technically, it shouldn't change anything. Look, I really dislike the kind of morality police, particularly when they are policing things that are consensual. But the fact is that whether or not it should change anything, whether or not it makes it any more unethical, any more immoral, which I don't think that it does, whether the wife is pregnant or not pregnant, whether it was a clothed, you know, member, or whether it was a naked member that he was sending. But I think what it does do is it ups our disgust factor in a way that makes it increasingly difficult to imagine how his public self can be mended, and can be mended in sufficient time to make him a useful advocate for progressive issues going into the 2012 election cycle.
Mike, your thoughts on this? The picture's out. There's a pregnant wife. What's it change, if anything?
Ed, I can tell you this, after defending Weiner on your show on Monday night, I went home and had my wife raise hell with me most of the night. And unfortunately, that's the sentiment I see developing across this country. It's always been my inclination, and most progressives do want to think, and they want to take the side of the underdog. But in the last 2 days, it's very difficult to do that. After reading the sophomoric texting that you saw come out of Anthony Weiner, the thing you can conclude that you almost have to say he's suffering from some kind of delayed, arrested adolescent development. It's like reading a dialogue that you might expect between Napoleon Dynamite and Eddie Haskell the first day they discover sex. It's very odd.
So have you changed your mind, Mike? Have you changed your mind on this issue?
Ed, it's impossible not to. And, you know, you did have it right Monday, but I have to tell you this. You want to believe a guy like this because he has such a great history of always doing and saying the right thing for people. And it's very difficult to get past what's happened here. But I look at it a different way. I see this as, you know, on Monday the story was about childlike antics. Now it's changed to where you have this man-child calling this porno queen, telling her that he wants her to spin her story in a way that looks favorable to him. It's a brand new story, Ed. In this emerging story, you add to that the pregnant wife, it's very difficult for people to defend. And I'm a guy that is always there defending that underdog.
Now, we know what the right wing does, and we know what the right wing is all about. And when Andrew Breitbart came out and said that he had an X-rated picture, I said, game over. There's no way that they are not going to have that get out some way. And this is going to be very, very hurtful and very damaging. It's going to change the dynamic, and it's going to change a lot of things. And now you have got Democrats who are on record saying that they think that he should leave the Congress. And so, Melissa, what about that? What about elected Democrats stepping out saying it's time for him to make a move? Does that change anything?
Now that changes everything. And let's be really clear. The world is not fair. I live in Louisiana. I'm a constituent of David Vitter. Right, I understand that this is not necessarily a situation of fairness. It's not, you know, putting one bad thing next to another and determining which one is most awful or most in violation of congressional ethics. That is not what is going on here. This is about politics. And so, just like in the 2008 election cycle, you know, Sarah Palin and her family were able to survive the fact that she had a pregnant out of wedlock daughter, when we know the Obamas would never have been able to survive that fact. This is the reality that Breitbart knows it, and the thing is, Weiner knew it when he did it.
Well, now his colleagues know it. His colleagues know
it. That's right.
Who wants to sponsor a bill with him? Who wants to go to fundraiser with him? Who's going to stump for him?
Nobody
becomes politically toxic. Oregon Congressman Earl Blumenauer, he said he wants Weiner to step down. He said that earlier tonight on this network.
As a member of the Democratic Party, if you think your Democratic colleague Anthony Weiner should resign,
I I don't see how you serve effectively after this amazingly egregious behavior, lying to the public. I think your credibility is shot, and I think Anthony would be better served moving on to something else.
Mike, isn't that it? Effectively serve, yeah. To work with other colleagues, to be respected, to be considered a voice of reason, one that's not troubled terribly? What about that?
Well, Weiner needs to do right now, Ed, and you said it in the beginning of the show, he doesn't need to be worrying about his political career. It's toast. He needs to focus on helping his wife get through this very difficult thing. She, you know, he's the one that put her into this mess. He needs to think about himself and the character flaws, these fundamentals that he needs to get under control in his life so he can be a good father for that child when that child is born. If I were a political advisor, if I were his legal advisor, or just a close friend, those are the things I'd be talking to Anthony Weiner about. Political career, don't worry about that right now. It really is toast.
Mike, your opinion of Andrew Breitbart?
Well, Breitbart, look, that's the worst thing about this story. Here's a guy who's had no credibility. We've seen him in the past phony up stories, yeah. Phony up videos. He's the kind of guy you expect to talk about aliens and monkey people.
He fell into it.
Yeah, every now and then, every squirrel gets a nut. But I got to tell you something, that doesn't change the way most progressives should look at him.
That's right.
It's like the National Enquirer on the Johnny Edwards story. They still are the people who talk about UFOs and monkey people most of the time. That is Breitbart.
And finally, right. Melissa Harris-Perry, let me ask you, where do the Democrats politically go from here? How do they distance themselves from this?
Yeah, look, I mean, let me just add to that. When targeted by Andrew Breitbart, you want to be Shirley Sherrard, not Anthony Weiner. Like, that's, you just want to be really clear about where you're standing. And the fact is, what Democrats have to do from here on out is recognize that the world is not fair, that the scrutiny is serious. Maybe it's time for a little, you know, Twitter conversation that Nancy Pelosi could bring together, you know, basic rules of how to behave, discuss the fact that going into 2012, this is not going to be just about policy. This is not going to be just about issues. It's also going to be ugly, mudslinging, down in the dirt politics, and so we're going to have to be ready to do that kind of work, too.
Well, his wife is pregnant. They're going to have a baby. He needs a job. He needs money coming in. He needs health care. He needs benefits. He might be thinking about that, and that might be one of the reasons why he's doing everything he possibly can to hang on.
Look, every American in the country is in that position. Everybody is holding on to tough jobs, and that's why people at this point are coming into work early and they're saving even more money. I mean, if you know that you are in a precarious position, you don't tweet your erect penis, openly. Like, this is not the behavior of someone who acts like they are trying to protect and care for the very precarious position that they find themselves in.
Melissa Harris-Perry, you couldn't have said it any better. I appreciate your comments tonight.
Thanks.
Along with you, Mike Papantonio, thanks so much for joining us.